Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna talk about a new knife from Kaiser Knives out of China in collaboration with one of my favorite overall designers, who is Dirk Pinkerton. He is very well known for his awesome, very aggressive looking Wharncliffe blades. If you are following my channel, you have seen a couple of his designs. This is unfortunately my only custom knife built directly by Mr. Pinkerton. This is his little warning fixed blade in some gorgeous Vegas Forge Matrix Damascus. Absolutely gorgeous, super thinly hollow ground, aggressive Wharncliffe fixed blade. Really, really good looking, and certainly an absolute masterpiece. And he also does a lot of collaboration with some Chinese companies, for example Kaiser, as well as Concept. And this one here is a smaller EDC piece that he is building with Kaiser, and these are the more affordable versions of this knife. This is the Kaiser Shard, and there has been a full titanium Kaiser Shard available for quite some time, and now they have released these more affordable options of the Shard line, where they have been going with some more affordable handle materials instead of titanium. There is a yellow G10 version available, which is this one here, and there is also a greenish blackish micarta handle available with a stone wash blade. Here we have the yellow and black washed version, and the steel instead of S35VN on the premium model. This in the Vanguard line is N690, which is a non-powder form, very stainless but still quite edge retaining steel that is also used a lot in some Italian knives. So certainly a good budget steel, and a very nice iteration of the Kaiser Shard. First off, some little infos about me. Please check out my ongoing giveaway that's running at the moment, where you can win some nice knives and gear. Everything will be linked in the top right corner there. And also check me out on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. This is also needed to enter into the international giveaway. Also, check out my Patreon, where you can find some more information as well as early access to all my videos by supporting the channel in any of the tiers. And now let's get back to this little Wharncliffe knife. So it's certainly a very compact folder here, the Kaiser Shard. Let's take a look at the specs of this knife. So we have an overall length of 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters with a blade length of 2.25 inches or 5.7 centimeters and a blade stock of 0.11 inches or 2.8 millimeters. Steel, as I said before, is N690 by Böhler. And we have a handle length of 3.25 inches or 8.3 centimeters. And the weight is very, very lightweight at just 50 grams or 1.75 ounces. The prices on these Vanguard shards is at $59. Big difference between this model and the Bladesmith series is also the pocket clip. Here we have a deep carry black stone washed overloop spring clip on the Bladesmith series Kaiser Shard. It's a 3D milled pocket clip. On smaller knives like these that you most likely will carry in your fifth pocket, I think a spring clip, an overloop deep carry clip, is probably the better version. I also like how they did it here. So instead of doing countersunk screws, they just screwed it in from the other side, so there is nothing to interfere with your clip. It would be nice to see an inlaid clip, but as it is, it's actually a nice springy steel clip that works very well in and out of the pocket. It has enough clearance there and also carries very, very deep, as you can see right here. So pocket clip, very nicely executed, very functional, and also very appropriate for the overall size and design of this knife. And I like that everything matches the black and yellow theme that you have going on here on the Shard. Other than that, we have a very nice aggressive Wharncliffe blade shape that is very well known by Dirk Pinkerton. We have also a very long run of jimping. He also likes his jimping for sure. We don't have any jimping on the handle scales. We see that sometimes on designs of his, but here we just have the long run of jimping on the spine, and it's just very well spaced out. It is exactly in the point where my thumb lands when I hold it in a saber grip, and surprisingly enough, even though we only have a handle length of 3.25 inches, with my small to medium hands, you know, I wear a size 7.5 sterile glove, I can squeeze on all my four fingers. So if I want to, it's a little bit cramped, but I can fit all my four fingers on there. If I space them out a little bit, the pinky hangs up here in the back of the handle, but it still feels very secure. If I use it as a utility blade, which you mostly do with these kind of Wharncliffe blades, it's very comfortable and fits really well in the overall hand if you don't have very large hands. We also have a very large slot for your lanyard hole here in the back, nicely integrated between these two screws, and certainly offers a lot of space for people that want to add a lanyard to this smaller kind of knife. So very well executed there. The liners that are not inset but just put under the G10 scales are also nicely black washed and fit really well into the overall design. They have some slight skeletonization to make the knife a little bit lighter weight. It's overall a liner lock design with easy access to that lock bar, as you can see right here. The blade runs on a nice ball bearing pivot, and it has a very strong detent and a great action, especially considering the lightweight nature of this blade. Perfectly centered right there, and also the lock up and overall fit and finish here on this Kaiser knife is very well done. Here you can check out the lockup, very nice engagement, and as I said before, absolutely no play. The finish on the yellow G10, which you also don't see that often, and really has a very good contrast with the black wash blade as well as hardware and liners, is finished very smoothly. You just have these signature shard millings in the forward part that look a little bit like a bolster. You have the same milling on the titanium version, so they just carried that over. But overall, you really have enough grip on this knife. This milling here really adds as a nice indexing point for your index finger on either side, and then coupled with the jimping on the spine and the very ergonomic and well-feeling handle, this actually feels very secure in the hand, even though it's a smaller overall knife. The pocket clip in a regular kind of saber grip is noticeable, but doesn't cause any hot spot. It just is there and you can feel it a little bit. It has not a uncomfortable feel in the hand. There is nothing that really pokes into your hand. We have no backspacer but two standoffs that are done in the same kind of finishing. Once again, the action is what surprised me the most. You can middle finger flick it, you can thumb flick it, and you can also open it slowly and control. But this is the hardest part because they actually went for a pretty strong overall detent. I hope I can show you that here on the closing. So a very defined and strong detent, which makes this knife very, very fun and a great backup folder or just a small urban carry. You can pretty much do all the things you need to do, opening letters, opening packages, cutting off strands from clothing, doing some light food preparation with N690, which is a very stainless steel. You can certainly do that as well, but it's certainly a little bit limited in terms of blade length. But if you only need a small knife, this could certainly function as your primary carry. But I think for most people, a knife with a 2.25 inch blade length is more of a backup or fifth pocket carry, and it certainly works really well for that. And I think with this particular version is that it also doesn't look as scary and as aggressive because it has a bright colored handle. So for people that are a little bit scared from bladed objects, this could certainly be also a nice option for a carry in a more populated area, for example, an office or something like that. This could be a great little carry for that, or even for a woman, this could be a great option. The blade itself and all the markings on the blades are done pretty tastefully. Here we have the Kaiser logo, which is not overly large there. We have N690. I don't know why they always put those unneeded model numbers on there. I think they are for no good use for anybody on the blade. Here we have Shard, and then they put in the nicely executed Dirk Pinkerton logo that is certainly very well executed. We have, of course, a flat grind here on this Wharncliffe blade, and a nice and symmetrically ground edge. Good plunge grind there, and also the edge is nicely cleared. Of course, no forward finger trail or something like that. Nice and puncture friendly tip, certainly nothing you should pry with. We have some chamfers alongside the edges of the jimping as well as on the edge of the blade there. The jimping is nice and grippy but not overly abrasive, so very well executed on the jimping there. And just overall a very well made smaller knife and a great option here at $59 in my opinion. Now let's do our standard kind of size comparisons. Move the box here out of the way so we have a little bit more space. For our larger size comparisons, here we have the F95NL. You notice I have zoomed in a little bit because this is certainly a smaller blade. And then we have the Shirogorov Neon Zero at the bottom. Certainly both of them are quite a lot larger than our regular kind of benchmark EDC blades. The Benchmade full size bug out at the top and the Para 3 at the bottom. You can see both of them are also quite a bit larger there. Cutting edge wise, we are just a little bit less than the Para 3, so that's where the 50-50 choice comes in on the Spider Coast to take away a little bit from their cutting edge. If you take a look at the thickness, it's thinner than the Para 3. If you take a look at blade stock thickness, it is going to be thinner here as well. If you compare it to the bug out, the full size bug out, stock thickness is pretty similar, maybe even slightly thicker, and handle thickness seems to be pretty close, pretty similar here to the Para to the Benchmade bug out in handle thickness. Also, overall, a feel in the hand is actually quite hand filling, even though it's a smaller kind of blade, but the thickness really feels quite well in the hand. Then some other comparisons that are more along the same size. We have, for example, here the Spyderco Reinhold Rhino, which is a little bit longer, same kind of cutting edge, a little bit more ergonomic here because it has a very, very big emphasis on the ergonomics here. A very oddly shaped handle that actually feels very good in hand. Here I had to swap out the clip for this bug out clip, but it's not as free falling with the compression lock as, for example, the Kaiser here. Some other Kaiser knives and a concept to compare. Here we have a very oddly shaped knife from Kaiser that I have reviewed. This is the Cyberblade, size-wise very similar, but much, much broader and more cumbersome to carry. Then I have the Concept Mini Cryo, which is going to be quite a bit larger. This is also not a large knife. We have a sub 3-inch blade, but much larger than the Shard right there. And then some other smaller knives to compare it to that you might know. For example, here we have the CRKT Pilar, which is going to be larger, but with less cutting edge, as you can see right here. And then I have some automatic knives because these are limited in blade size. These are actually very close here in size. We have the Launch 11 from Kershaw and the Burker Plus Shamsher at the bottom here. And you can see it's a little bit larger than both of those, but these are the smallest folding knives that I have in the collection because these are limited in blade size in my country. So very close to these two knives, nice and compact, still managing to get a four-finger grip, even though when you're a little bit crammed on the handle. Other than that, it's a three-finger knife for most people, but a very comfortable one at that. And certainly a great option here with the yellow G10, which you don't see that often in the knife market. Certainly something to change it up a little bit, but also the Micarta version would be certainly a great option. Good clip, very good action, especially for the size, N690 steel, and an affordable price point at $59. With an overall design from a very talented and pretty underrated designer, in my opinion, Dirk Pinkerton. So this seems to be a great option for a fifth pocket carry or just a smaller EDC piece for people that like smaller knives, the Kaiser Knives Shard. So this was my review of this knife. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments below and I will answer you there as soon as possible. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and check out my giveaway. It will also be linked at the end of the video. And also check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order. Also, you will find a link to the Kaiser Knives website for some more information about the Kaiser Knives Sharp. So thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.